But tell us about Kyrie.
Just right foot injury. That's all I can tell you. We'll know more tomorrow.
Okay. All right.
What'd you think about the way Dante stepped up to his game?
He was big to start and then to, have to play both ends of tonight. I thought he did a great job defensively and offensively. It's not easy guarding Simons. He's one of the best in the league in putting the ball in the basket. So, but I thought, just playing off of Luka and Kai, and then we lose Kai, and now it's just Luka and Dante out there. I thought Dante did a really good job of attacking other double teams and getting to the rim. And then I thought one of the big plays was down the stretch where Luka found him on the roll, and he throws out to Derrick Jones Jr. for the three. It was, that was really, really a nice play.
When you guys made the rally against OKC, you pointed to that quarter as that's a quarter. We were desperate on defense. And starting from that quarter, for the next six quarters, you guys allowed 22 points per quarter. Do you think you guys have found something on defense, or has it just been a matter of, like, better effort?
No, I think I think they show that they can, play defense. And when you're, desperate, you kind of tell on yourself. And I thought in that Oklahoma City game, we were playing disadvantage, defensively, where we had to take the ball out of Shea's hand, and then we're scrambling, and then we're finishing plays with the rebound. And so I think, again, the depth that we have, if we can play that way, that's great. But right now we're running into some injuries here. So, but I thought the fourth quarter defense was good on the road against a team that plays extremely hard, and they just kept coming, and they kept the game close and striking distance, and we made some good stops and then capitalized on the offensive end.
Just another question about Dante. What does it say about he hadn't been put in that situation in, I don't know, in an NBA game in years?
Yeah, I think, but he was just in the finals, I think, in Europe. So I think he understands that, the level of basketball, of being in a close game, it's, at the end of the day, it's basketball, and you rely on your strengths. And again, I've said this about Dante, his basketball IQ is extremely high. He knows how to play. He's not afraid of the moment, and you can see that. He's attacking, getting to the basket, and making plays. And so when you have a third ball handler like Dante, it just makes the game so much easier for Kai and Luka and everyone else who's on the floor.
What did you think of the resolve that you guys showed? That sometimes when an important guy like that goes down, it's tough to do.
Yeah, I thought there was great carryover to start the game from our last game against Utah, and then the injury took I think some of our aggression away. We were just a little bit, settling, and give Portland credit again. They play hard for 48 minutes, and they made a game of it, but. There's a lot of good stuff. There's going to be a lot of guys playing. Omax, I thought, did a good job. I thought Keith did a good job in his minutes out there for us tonight. So we're going to have to rely on our depth here. And I thought AJ kind of gave us a spark with the breakaway dunk that got us going a little bit there too.
The offense mixed some things up in the fourth quarter with Derek Lively and ball screening actions like the stack pick and roll. He's still getting adjusted to the NBA. What are your thoughts on how he's kind of handled those different screening actions when you add some extra layers to it?
Yeah, I think Derek's done a great job of understanding what he has to do. Being able to roll or understand if there's a channel five or if someone's trapping Luka or the ball handler, just to be able to, understand. So he's been a great receiver of running his routes. We ran a play and he got the lob. He understands when he rolls that there's an opportunity for him to score, and he does it with force. He has great hands, and Luka trusts him. So I think he's done a great job of being able to read the different things that are taking place after the screen when he sets the screen.
Yeah, it seemed he opened some things up with re-screens when they kind of went with Jabari Walker in the fourth quarter. What did you see from Lively with rescreening and opening things up like that?
Yeah, they read. They did a lot of things. They trapped Luka right off the first play of the game. And it just showed that Lively was paying attention to what we thought was coming, and he benefited from it. So I think it's just, again, his IQ, is his awareness of seeing what's taking place with Luka or Kai when they're being double teamed. Also, to be, you know, with the rescreening, to be able to flip the screen, he understands what Luka wants, and they have a great partnership that's developing, right, you know, on the fly.
One more question, I apologize, but Blazers TV supposedly said that Kyrie was taken out of the arena, and I didn't hear that from anywhere else, but it sparked all this stuff on the internet. To your knowledge, did Kyrie, was he, has he been here the whole time?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, when somebody, something like that is said on TV, it just goes crazy. I don't know why they would say something like that. That wouldn't be the case. So,
well,
all, he stayed in the arena.
All right? Reporting is not... all factual, is it? Or should we all believe it?
We got to check some kind of...
I'm not here to like interview that. You, but I think he hasn't left the building. He's still here.
That's what I wanted to check.
Okay.
Thank you.
Cool.
So I asked Jason about the fact that probably it's been several years in an NBA game where you were in a position where you were scoring, asked to score a lot of points. But he noted, you know, your play over in Europe and playing for a championship, that maybe this wasn't as big of a deal tonight to you as maybe it seemed to some of us.
No, I think for me it's something I, you know, went over to Europe and I was doing. You know, I was looked at more offensively, but I think, you know, my outlook here is being able to play off, you know, Luka, be able to play off guys and just be smart on the offensive end. And tonight I think I did that well and was able to create for myself, you know, getting into lane is what I do, and you know, when they're all looking at Luka, I can just go past my guy. So that's what I try and do.
Well, how did it feel to have a big offensive night?
It felt good. You know, I think, you know, just kind of where I've been at with my shot and everything, just to, you know, hit those two threes and feel confident. I think everyone's been saying keep shooting. There was a couple I should have shot and they were telling me to shoot it. So it's been something I've been working on for, you know, ever since last game, and I'll continue to keep working on so I can, you know, be that offensive threat from the three.
What's the feeling around the team when Kai goes down and, you know, you kind of have to regroup a little bit for something like through something like that?
Yeah, no, I think one of the biggest things in with our team is the next man up mentality. You know, you see that right now. You know, me as an example. You know, we have Grant down, we have Josh down, Maxi down, you know, guys being able to step up. So, you know, hopefully he's not out for too long, but, you know, we have a deep roster that are willing and ready to step up.
There were times where, or well, often you guarded some of the toughest assignments today. What was important for you in handling those types of matchups to help set the tone for the defense?
Yeah, I think picking up full court, that's one thing. You know, trying to tire them out. You know, they'll hit a couple shots here and there on me, but, you know, I think once it gets into the fourth and late in the game, after I've been doing it the whole game, that's when it kind of really shows. And even if I'm not on them and they're missing the shots, you know, that was the goal of mine. You know, they hit some tough shots on me, and, you know, hats off to them, but I think it was just a grinded out game, tire them down, and, you know, once it hit that fourth quarter, you know, hopefully they slowed down. Which,
you're probably supposed to Kyrie. Is anyone on the team wondering, you know, how hard that hits when you see that was a scary collision?
Yeah, man, it's tough. But, nah, you know, we got to have his back, next man mentality. That's what he would want. And I'm glad we came out with the victory.
Were you able to visit with him after?
Oh, yeah, of course. He was right there waiting for us at the door when we came in.
Okay.
Yeah, he was good. He was good. Great spirits. Just happy that he's okay. I mean, when we got in the locker room, we all saw on social media how it looked on the picture. So it... obviously, it didn't look too good. So hopefully, have him back soon.
Okay. What did you think about the way you guys responded after something like that happens? It's not always easy.
Yeah, it's kind of hard, you know, especially the opposing team seeing that and gives them life, you know, a little bit, which sucks, but it's part of the game. And I think we took their best punch when they cut the lead, I guess, to two or something like that. And happy that we still have 77 on our side, come down there, weather the storm with his decision-making and Dante Exum, obviously, you know, having an incredible game, and the bigs just doing their job, rolling, rebounding. So it was all a team effort.
So 10 and 0 and 2 also had their share of this.
Yeah, we did. You know, it was great. You know, I haven't played this many minutes, I guess, since probably the beginning of the last year or something like that. I mean, 36 minutes. So I felt good to be out there for that long and help carry the team with the win.
How helpful is it to have like another bigger guard like Dante alongside Luka? Like, what kind of challenges does that pose to the opposing team?
It helps out tremendously just because it's another ball handler out there, a true point guard, got it. Does decision making, gets in the paint, creates for others. Good finisher around the paint, as you all saw today. And what he did great for us was to set the tone defensively. Him picking up full court, asking us for a sub, you know, it shows that he's going hard on both ends of the floor. And we appreciate that. And that definitely helped us and propelled us to the victory.